In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Thus says the Lord, for three crimes of Israel and for four, I will not revoke my word. Because they sell the just man for silver and the poor man for a pair of sandals. They trample the heads of the weak into the dust of the earth and force the lowly out of the way. Son and father go to the same prostitute, profaning my holy name, upon garments taken in pledge. They recline beside any altar. And the wine of those who have been fined, they drink in the house of their God. Yet it was I who destroyed the Amorites before them, who were as tall as the cedars and as strong as the oak trees. I destroyed their fruit above and their roots beneath. It was I who brought you up from the land of Egypt and who led you through the desert for 40 years to occupy the land of the Amorites. Beware, I will crush you into the ground as a wagon crashes when laden with sheaves. Flight shall perish from the swift, and the strong man shall not retain his strength. The warrior shall not save his life, nor the bowman stand his ground. The swift of foot shall not escape, nor the horseman save his life. and the most stout-hearted of warriors shall flee naked on that day, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remember this, you who never think of God.
Remember this, you who never think of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth? Though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you.
Remember this, you who never think of God.
When you see a thief, you keep pace with him, and with adulterers, you throw in your lot. To your mouth, you give free rein for evil. You harness your tongue to deceit.
Remember this, you who never think of God.
You sit speaking against your brother, against your mother's son. You spread rumors. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes.
Remember this, you who never think of God.
Consider this, you who forget God, lest I rend you and there be no one to rescue you. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
Remember this, you who never think of God. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw a crowd around him, he gave orders to cross to the other shore. A scribe approached and said to him, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens, and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." Another of his disciples said to him, "Lord, let me go first and bury my father." But Jesus answered him, "Follow me, and let the dead bury their dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
There is nothing bad when we come across with someone or a person happy or enthusiastic enough when we offer things to him or to her. Alayan mo ng trabaho, alayan mo ng promotion, alayan mo ng isang magandang bagay o kung ano man yan, marahil ilan po sa atin dito may iilan masigasig o talagang napaka-sincere ng kanilang pagtugon sa isang natatanging tawag o marahil isang magandang tawag na nasa harapan nila. The story of our gospel would give us the person of this scribe and the other disciple who expressed their desire to follow Jesus. I will follow you wherever you go. And again, we might hear a very enthusiastic and ready disciple. Susunod kahit saan pumunta si Jesus. Susunod kahit saan pumaroon si Jesus. But Jesus answered them by saying that to follow me, it will be uncertain. There will be discomforts. There will be at least setting of priorities. As if Jesus was telling that man, walang problema kung susunod ka. Walang problema kung ikaw ay masigasig na tumugon sa akin. Pero kung susunod, humanda sa mga dapat harapin. Humanda sa mga dapat pagdaanan o sa mga dadaanan, sa mga dapat bitawan, and eventually, sa mga dapat pangatawanan ng ating pagtugon. Minsan po ay tila napakadali na lamang sumagot sa mga madaming imbitasyon sa buhay. Or on the one hand, we tend to be as some Bible commentators would describe this scribe to be over-enthusiastic. Oo na lang ng oo, masigasig kung masigasig, tugon kung tugon, yes kung yes. Pero hindi tinitignan ang mga bagay na pwedeng mangyari. Maganda man, makahulugan man, hindi man maganda o yung mga bagay na tama lang o katamtaman lang. But let our enthusiasm be packed with sincere and honest following of Jesus. Hindi yung susunod o mamahalin lang ang Diyos, pero sa oras na dadaan sa krus, may pagdadaanan, ayaw na. Hindi naman susunod lang kapag buenas, kapag komportable lang, o kapag ang gusto lang natin ang matutupad. But my dear brothers and sisters, when we mean to follow Jesus, when we say, yes, I will follow you wherever you go, we give our yes to both joys and sufferings, to both consolations and desolations, to both crosses and resurrections. Hindi po minamasama ng Diyos ang masaya at masigasig nating pagtugon sa Kanya. He just wants us to be enthusiastic as we answer and follow Him, to answer and face what is ahead of us. When we respond to God and when we respond in enthusiasm to God, to our daily life, to whatever or whoever is offered to us, let us not only be sincere with our answers, but how we shall also live our answers.
Please stand.
We bring our needs before God our Father, whose Son has gone before us and has called us to follow Him. With confidence, we pray for the grace to accept that calling. For every petition, we shall say, Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
That the leaders of the church and all those engaged in preaching the Word of God may persevere in their commitment to follow Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
That our community may be renewed from day to day through faith in the Word of God, calling them to a better life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
That those of us who have lost hope because of our sins may realize that Christ, our leader, walks with us and carries our burden. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
That those who are weakened by sickness or infirmity may be assured of God's comfort through the care and support of their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
That the dead who follow Jesus may enter God's presence forever in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for one another, and for the prayers of our brothers and sisters joining us through online streaming. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, give us the grace to follow your Son.
God our Father, in our desire to follow in the footsteps of your Son, make us one in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of this sacred gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Bas-basan.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For this week, Monsignor Rolly will be out for a silent retreat as a part of his past 30-day retreat. He will be on a 5-day retreat this week, and we humbly ask you to accompany him with your prayers, as he also promises his prayers for all of us during this week of encounter with the Lord. Thank you very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Let us go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.